All right, so I'm gonna be making this loungewear out of these $5 blankets that I got from Five Below. So if you have any blankets laying around, you should definitely use them. So I just took the blanket and I folded it in half so that the wrong side of the blanket was on the outside of the fold, and I'm folding it vertically, so lengthwise. The next thing I did was I measured 18 inches up from the bottom and I made a mark, and I basically just kept making an 18 inch mark all across so that way I could connect all of the points to make one horizontal line. Hopefully y'all can see it, but the horizontal line is the blue line here on the screen. Then after that, I just cut off the fringe part of the blanket, so on the bottom and the sides, just because it would make sewing a bit easier on my needle. So really quickly, I just wanted to give a major thank you to everyone who voted on my post here on the screen, asking you guys what tutorial you wanted to see next. I do read your comments and I do check the votes, so thank you so much. And I just wanted to let you guys know that if you ever have any suggestions or requests for what you would like me to make a tutorial on, don't hesitate to message me on Instagram or leave a comment or email me or whatever it is. I always want to make sure that I'm making tutorials that you guys actually want to see. And if you like how I explain things, if you find my tutorials easy to follow, then please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and tell your friends and your family about my channel and my tutorials, and just spread the love all around. All right, let's continue. And this is what it looked like with the fringe cut off of the bottom and the sides. All right, so starting at the top of the blanket, I measured 9 inches down and then I made a mark, and the mark is about 1 inch wide. And I repeated the same step on the other side. So I went to the top of the other side of the blanket and measured 9 inches and made a 1 inch wide mark. Okay, so starting at that bottom line, the first line that we drew, I went in about 1 inch in from the edge and I drew a vertical line. And now I'm just going to connect that vertical line. I'm going to extend it all the way up till it reaches the end of that horizontal mark that we made in the previous step. So you'll see what I mean. So this is what it looked like, and I just repeated the same step on the other side of the bottom line. So I just went in by 1 inch and then drew a vertical line that connected from that bottom line to that small horizontal mark that we made in the previous steps. Then after that, I just cut straight across that horizontal line that I first drew. After that, I just stitched right on top of those blue lines. So basically like a kind of upside down L shape. Now, I'm not even gonna lie, when I first started trying to stitch this, my machine was not having it because the layers were so thick. But then I realized it was because I had it on the wrong settings. So just wanna remind you that these are the settings here that you should be using for your sewing machine. So this is what it looked like after I stitched along the blue lines. It basically created a sort of tube. So this area here is where the blanket was originally folded, and I want to get rid of that folded area. So I just cut straight down and I stopped where that first horizontal line was. And you'll see once I do it that it now has an open flap the way that the other side of the blanket has that open flap. And then I just cut about a half inch away from that stitched line on both sides of the blanket. So this is what it looked like after I cut off the edge. And then the next thing I did was I just peeled back that top part so that I could basically open it up like that. And now I just want to create a sleeve part on both sides. So I'm going back to that first, to that bottom part that I first cut, and I'm cutting that in half so that I have two separate pieces. And then I'm just getting rid of the fold, so I'm just cutting a straight line down where the folded fabric is to create two separate pieces like this. And then after that, I just decided to stitch about a half inch up from the bottom edge all the way across. So this is what the two rectangles look like after I stitched along the bottom edge. And when I open it up, it looks like this. So I'm going to take one of the rectangular pieces, which is basically our sleeve, and I'm bringing it back up to the top of the blanket, and I'm just reopening that top part. And I'm laying out the sleeve so that it's open and the right side is facing up. And I'm literally just going to stitch these two pieces together. I'm going to stitch them together with a zigzag stitch. So here you can see that I'm literally just bringing the two pieces so that they're side by side as close as possible. And then I'm putting it under my presser foot and then literally just doing a zigzag stitch all the way down. So once I got to the bottom of the sleeve and the bottom of the armhole, I just wanted to make sure that both ends were lining up. So I just lightly stretched the sleeve a little bit, and then I just continued stitching. So this is what the sleeve looked like once I connected it to the open armhole. And then the next thing I did was I just starting from the armhole seam, I measured and marked 8 inches. And this is basically where the shoulder part will be. And then starting at the bottom of the sleeve, I just eyeballed about a half inch down from the top edge. And then I decided to do a straight stitch all the way, stopping at the bottom of that mark that I just made. And by the way, that mark should be about a half inch long. And then on the other side, I measured 8 inches as well, starting at the armhole opening inward. And this is what it looked like after I stitched down the top edge of the sleeve. So now I actually have a legit sleeve. The next thing I did was I just serged the raw edge of the side seam, and also below and above the sleeve. Geez, struggling. And this is what it looked like. And then I literally just repeated the same steps with the other sleeve and armhole. And this is what it looked like after I finished repeating the previous steps. And the next thing I did was I basically aimed to cut a straight line down the middle. So I folded the robe in half. And then I just took my scissors and I just cut through only one layer, so just that outer layer, along the fold all the way up. And y'all, let me just tell you, I was so nervous. I kept getting scared that I was cutting through all of the layers and that like the tutorial was just gonna be a sham, but I made it. So this is what it looked like after I opened up the full robe. So now you can see that is basically done. And so my original plan was to serge along the outer like raw edges, like along the bottom and the open flaps. But when I first started serging it, I didn't like how it looked. So you can see here, this is how it started looking. It just looked too like unfinished. So instead what I did was I just did a straight stitch along those areas, like the top of the neckline at the back, along the sleeves, along the open flaps of like where the robe opens, and then also a straight stitch along the bottom. And I think it made it look more natural, but it also helped to prevent like the robe from falling apart and fraying. And this is what the girl was giving. I think it looks super cute. I almost like wanna wear this outside, but it's definitely way too cold. If you like how this came out, leave me a heart emoji down below in the comment. And also be sure to check out part 2, where I'll show you guys how to make like shorts and then like a little tank top that you can wear underneath this to create a full loungewear set. So check out part 2. See you guys in the next one. Ciao.